money.
I don't have your money.
I know I'd be a lot happier with some extra cash.
Is this about money?
Oh, man, we got bills to pay, buddy.
Obviously, this is all about money.
I got to talk to you about money.
With practical tips and a focus on scripture, let's talk money with Dave and Reb from More Than Enough, the financial show that speaks to the heart of your money story. Real conversations about money for real people. Let's talk money.
Happy New Year! Surprise, Reb.
That's not what you're supposed to start the show with.
Well, you know what? This is the show. It's a brand new year. We're talking about change. Oops, did I introduce the subject already?
Yes,
I did. I know. But so I thought I'd change it up and surprise you, and it worked.
It did. I was expecting, are you ready to talk money?
Okay, so now I can say, are you ready to talk money, Reb?
Yes, I'm ready to talk money.
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year, everybody.
So, well, welcome to the show. This is the show where we talk about the hard issues around money. I'm Dave Van Oppen. I'm here with my lovely wife, Reb. I was waiting for a comment there, Rebecca.
I know. I am lovely, so there you go. Is that what you were waiting for a comment for?
You know, I just thought you'd give me the roll of the eyes or something.
I didn't. I was taking the compliment. Thank you very much.
I love it. So beginning of the new year, we're starting the show. Of course, we're in anticipation of making some changes in 2018. This is the time where most of us sit down at some point, whether we've done that over the last couple of weeks or maybe we're doing it in the next couple of weeks, and just think about change. Think about 2017, what happened, the good, the bad, the ugly, and then really looking forward to 2018. Some of us just want to shut the door on 2017 and say, you know what, I don't want to go back there. And there is some value in taking a glance backwards. We often say in the when we're talking about money that we want to look in the rearview mirror just periodically, but keep our focus on what's happening in front of us, like the front view mirror,
if you see
that car analogy. So, Reb, I'm sure you have a verse to start off this first show of the new year.
Right.
Something totally inspirational.
Well, it's the Word of God, so I hope it inspires us this morning. For those of you who haven't caught on, we're talking about change. And the world we live in is changing rapidly around us. Circumstances change within our families, our communities, our churches. There are things we don't like that are changing. There are things maybe that we do like that are changing. But I've chosen a passage of scripture. It's actually a couple of chapters in Deuteronomy. And it's the time when Moses was not ending his life, but the Lord was calling him home to himself and was taking him up on the mountain. And Moses was preparing the people of Israel to receive Joshua as a new leader. And I don't want to read all of it, but you basically start in Deuteronomy 31 and you read the next few chapters. And one of the things that Moses says, he gathers the people of Israel and he says, I'm 120 years old today. I can't go in and out any longer.
I'm getting old.
I'm getting old.
I think that's the paraphrase there.
Yes. And I can't cross over the Jordan. Mm. And for any of us who know the story, there is a reason why he wasn't going in with them. But the Lord your God himself will cross before you. And he was going to look after the nations. He was establishing Joshua. Joshua was already being mentored by Moses. And the people of Israel knew he would be taking over. But he says to them, you know, I'm going to take care of your enemies. And he calls them in Deuteronomy 31, verse 6, not to be afraid. He says, be strong and be of good courage. Don't fear nor be afraid of your enemy, for the Lord your God, he is the one who goes with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. Mm. And then the scripture keeps going, and he says it to Joshua. He reiterates those words, Joshua, don't be afraid. The Lord is with you. He goes before you. He's not forsaking you. He won't leave you. So don't be fearful or dismayed. And actually, then in Joshua, if we fast forward into Joshua 1, verse 9, that's a famous, well-known verse. Mm-hmm. Have I not told you, do not be dismayed or discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. I mean, he's reiterating it. So if I hear anything, one of the things that I want us to be thinking of today is that no matter what change we're facing in our and how we want to do our finances, because this is a financial show, we can be confident that the Lord is with us, that he cares about us so much that he is in the detail, and that he cared about the people of Israel so much. He was in the detail of reminding them, don't be afraid. This wasn't about, he wasn't saying, fear me, have raw awe and reverence for me. That wasn't the context of that word fear. This was, don't be trembling or dismayed because of the unknown ahead of you, because I am with you. And I've established Joshua as your leader. Now, interesting part is, because there's another piece to this, and I know I'm taking a bit of time because it's really important. Moses writes a song and sings it over Israel before he goes up the mountain to die. And it's all about reminding the people who God is of the faithfulness, reminding the people of their own hearts and they're prone to rebellion. And then he says this, so they learn the song because they don't know what he did in Egypt for them. So he's laying it all out for them. He gets them to sing it because he says, in the days ahead, you're going to be rebellious. Remember the rebellion. Remember what your heart is prone to, but remember how God takes care of you, how faithful he is, what he has done. And, you know, he says this, Moses finished speaking to all these words to Israel, and he said to them, set your hearts on all the words which I testify among you today, which you shall command your children to be careful to observe, all the words of the law, all the words that I've given you. Obey it, observe it, heed it, read it, know it. For it is not a futile thing for you, because it is your life. And by this word, you shall prolong your days in the land which you cross over the Jordan to possess. Those words, it is not a futile thing for you to heed the law. It is not a futile thing because it is your life. Mm-hmm. Now, what does that have to do with today? Well, I
was just going to say, some things don't change, Reb.
I know. I mean,
you know, we often... I get to the scripture and we're like, okay, Reb, is this a scripture that actually relates to money or not? But in this case, there's so many correlations between this new year, the old year, the transfer from the old to the new. Here we are on essentially the cusp of a new year, and you've read some scripture that talk about Moses transferring the cusp of new leadership.
Well, and you think about where Israel was at. Mm-hmm. This would be a scary time. One they knew, they saw Moses meeting with the Lord at the tabernacle. At the end of Deuteronomy, it says there was not a prophet like Moses who met with God face to face. They didn't know what kind of leader Joshua was going to be. They didn't know what the new land was going to be. They had heard stories of God's great things that he had done in Egypt. But they had... Like, this was change. This was scary.
But really interesting that Moses, there's a couple things. Right? If we go back to the actual Exodus from Egypt, they get to the Red Sea. Moses sticks his staff in the ground. They cross over. The Egyptians are swallowed up in the sea. And then Miriam sings a new song.
Yes.
And here we have... Moses now, they're at the, you know, entering a new land. They're entering a new phase, which is essentially the same spot as what they were when they were exiting Egypt. And Moses seems to reverse the order a little bit. So he says, well, we're going to start with a song, and I'm going to tell you what's going to happen next, that you're going to cross the Jordan, and you're going to do it in fact, very similar fashion to the exit from Egypt. The Lord's going to go before them. It's not exactly the same because it's a new generation. And so sometimes we're going to see that in our own lives where we're going to, you know, we'll look back and we'll say, well, the Lord did it this way before. And the reality is it may look similar, But there is a change. There is something different. There is uniqueness in how Joshua crosses into the
promised land. Well, that's really interesting because they do. He does divide the Jordan for them, and they cross over. And
there's no more staff that goes in. It's actually the Ark of the Lord that gets placed in the Jordan.
And they also put the stones of remembrance for the 12 tribes, right? They each take a stone and they put it in. Well, that's really interesting. I have never thought of it like that. But I think we're starting the year with this encouragement. We hope that you take from the Lord, that He is with you and He goes before you. Mm-hmm. And in the changes ahead, in what we know as taxes, business, if you're a small businessman, like as a business person.
In your financial life.
And your financial life in general. I'm just thinking of that, you know, you just being a business person. What does it mean? What does it mean for, minimum wage increase? And all of these things that are unknowns for us. But we can take these scriptures and say, He is the one who goes before us. He's saying, don't be afraid. He has made a way for us. And it is not a futile thing for us. It is our life to heed the word of the Lord. And the one reason I thought about this, and because we like to talk about the 2,350 verses that deal with mammon and money and possessions and our hearts, because this is a show about around the heart issues around money. And, you know, sometimes... you wonder about these verses. Why on earth does Rebecca say these things? And Dave teases me often about that. But in reality, it is all the same pile. Like, this word of God is applicable to every area of our life, to our finances, to our hearts, to our relationships. And if we don't heed it, you know, we have a choice to make. You know, he says it earlier in Deuteronomy, and I always get the words mixed up, but he says, today I set before you life and death. And we have a choice to choose life or to choose death. We can say, you know what? I don't know what the word of God says about money. I don't know what he's saying about stewardship or what is tithing or what does it mean to be generous and give? You know, maybe we need to take a look at the heart of the Father in 2018 and find out how generous he is. Because if I am to be like Christ, if I have Christ flowing through me, what does that mean in regards to generosity? What does that mean in regards to sharing? You know, we start asking those questions. It's exciting. And that's where life is. You know, the word of God came to humanity to show us that we don't measure up to the holiness of the Lord. It's the law. And Paul talks about it in the New Testament. We go according to the letter of the law. It's death. But the Spirit comes to bring life. You know, we read the Word of God and we think, man, yes, I don't measure this. Like, how do you do this? But the Spirit then blows into it and says, it's possible. It is possible to be as generous as God is, because we are His hands and feet on the earth. And when I read all this, this is the hope of what's ahead, because our society, we look at it, it can lead us into great distress just by seeing what's going on.
Just by watching the news. And here's the encouragement that we can take from these verses and from a lot of the verses that we read specifically about money is that we have this great confidence to know that as we seek first His kingdom, as we just get to know the heart of the Father, then that changes how we relate to the world around us. And again, this is the show about money, so we're going to talk specifically about money. And I love the quote. I mean, we all know the quote from Gandhi that said, "Be the change you want to see." And this is so appropriate in the area of finances, because that's actually something that if you look back on 2017, you take that glance backwards and go, you know what? I'm not terribly happy about what happened financially in our lives in 2017. Great. So we have the ability to sit down and say, what does it look like in 2018? I want to be the change. I don't want to complain about the grocery bill or all of that stuff that maybe we get sucked into when we're in those conversations, and say, I just want to speak life into my finances, but also into the finances of people around me as we have conversations. And so maybe that's the change you want to do. It's just simply have a better outlook or a more optimistic outlook. And you can do that because of the verses that you've read right here, Reb, where you're saying, we don't know what tomorrow is going to bring.
No, we don't.
But we do know that the Lord goes with us into tomorrow. And so we can go, I can have great confidence to know that, you know, maybe, yeah, there's some stress or there's some things as I look ahead and start planning financially that I don't know how I'm going to accomplish that. But the Lord goes before me into 2018. The Lord goes before me.
And I think it's remembering, you know, our propensity to fail. A lot of us are really grounded in knowing that we can fail. I mean, we're surrounded by you know, our weakness sometimes when we look at our finances, look at our bank account or look at our Visa bill or those things. You know, sometimes it's our own mistakes or our desire for the things of the world more than anything that gets us into debt trouble. Not always. There's a million reasons why we have debt. But to remember that He is with us and He loves us. Because I think one of the things, I think that Moses wanted to remind the people of, this is, you have every propensity to rebel, but God is faithful. And isn't that the story, the prodigal story? Because that, I think that prodigal story from the New Testament is a beautiful story and has become more and more beautiful to me in 2017 because I'm reminded how much I don't believe that I'm the beloved. I mess up the resources of God. I take His inheritance. I blow it. And then I'm in the pigsty with the pigs thinking, I'll go home and just be a servant in my father's house because there's food there. And I come home and He's got a robe and a ring and a feast and He's so glad to see me. And I think, man, but I messed up so badly. And I think that's a reminder for 2018 is we have to take the word of God and that love, that how He sees us as the beloved. We're His beloved. We're His sons and daughters. And we have forgotten that we've been made in the goodness of God. And that he wants to lead us. He wants to be face to face with us like He was with Moses. And He's made a way because of Christ, right? It's different. His relationship with Moses was different because Christ wasn't the intermediary for Moses and the Father. But we have Him. We have this beautiful relationships and access to it. But we're so mired sometimes in our own misery. And we failed financially. And I sometimes think we have to forgive ourselves.
Oh, absolutely. Right? We have to forgive ourselves.
We have to forgive ourselves and stop looking back and start looking forward and say, Father, I repent. Mm-hmm. But You're with me and You promised to help me and You've got a robe and You've got a feast. And how do we do this? It doesn't mean that we don't have to plan. It doesn't mean miracles are going to rain down from heaven and just, you know, wipe out all our debt.
The money tree grows in the backyard.
The money tree does. No, that's not always the way God works. He's not, you know, there's manna, but not necessarily money trees, right? Mm-hmm. He's got manna for us every day. He's got the bread of life Himself to give us, where we grow in relationship with Him. And as we're growing in relationship with Him, we're gaining hopefully some tools, either through a coach or accountability or studying the Bible of how to get practically out of debt. Because we know we're going toward the end of our show in the next 10 minutes. And of course, this is Practical Dave's show. So we need the practical things.
And we're going to have a whole series of shows coming up in January. So hang with us.
Just about change.
About change and how we navigate change and how that can affect us in terms of relationships with those around us. You're going to have to tune in and catch it because we're going to just be just unpacking all of this area with change. But today we really wanted to set the stage, and I'm going to reiterate that because I think it's really important for us to know that no matter the change, maybe 2017 was an awesome year and there were some great things that happened financially and you're moving ahead and you're connected with your spouse and you're doing the accountability stuff and you just want that to continue. Well, great, absolutely. But we live in this world where change happens so quickly. It just we can turn a corner and something looks different. And not always bad. We're not saying that it's always negative change, but just saying that change happens. And so knowing that the Lord goes before you and that the Lord can prepare you. Often in our conversation, Reb, we're talking about that God he isn't the keeper of secrets. He lets us know what he's up to. In fact, he wants to partner with us. And we see that all through Scripture. And we see that again here in the passages you read, where God's desire was that the Israelite nation would possess the promised land.
Right.
And that wasn't a new thing. In fact, the Israelites, you know, that was way back to Abraham. You know,
it wasn't about them having bigger and better and the land flowing with milk and honey. It was to display his glory. I mean, ultimately, we go into the promised land. We want our finances in order. To release the stress, most certainly, because that's often a motivator, that pain of stress. We want to deal with this money issue. But bottom line, it's a display of his glory when we can testify of how God has changed our lives and has helped us and equipped us and helped us pay off debt, helped us get us to a place where we can be more generous in our communities and with others, to pour his resources into his kingdom. And it's one thing you love to quote that verse, so that there is no poor among us, right? I mean, ultimately, it's for a kingdom purpose. Like it's just this, I know there's so much to this show, but bottom line is he is with us and he wants to encourage us for those of us who are despairing. We're his beloved, and he wants to go with us and go before us. He's around us and above us. He's within us, and we forget. And I think at the start of this year, in the changes that are happening all around us, we just want to hold on to the rock that he is our foundation. And taking the word of God at face value, you know, where we go back to those verses, it is not a futile thing to keep the law because it is life to us. But it's knowing the word and having the Spirit breathe life into that in our lives, which is so beautiful.
And I love the picture again as we see the Israelites crossing the Jordan, and that the Ark of the Covenant gets placed in a sense forward and at the beginning and leads the people as a symbol that God is going before them. And if there's a practical encouragement I want to leave with you this show is that the Lord goes before you, and we can make that correlation to say, whether it's through his word, whether it's through sitting down and reading the Bible and finding some encouragement in there, maybe it's a book you read in a sense of some of the resources that we have access to. Maybe it's doing a financial Bible study. Maybe it's being in relationship with people where you can actually be honest about your finances. Maybe that's the start. But knowing that no matter what the changes, no matter what the new looks like, that the Lord can go before you, and the Lord does go before you into this new year, into this new, again, we have no idea what tomorrow's going to bring or what 2018 is going
to
bring.
It was very interesting. I'm remembering now that when we moved to our new home and how God brought us to the land we're on now, like physically to the place where we live, your dad came and brought us stones and in a container, and they were like rocks of remembrance to remind us of God's faithfulness as we moved from one place to another. And I'm just thinking that maybe that's a practical piece, that at the beginning of this year, you sit down with your family and you write the faithful promises of God as you want, we're not saying you have to make a resolution, but you make a plan in your heart. You decide before the Lord with your family, Lord, we want to trust that you go before us. And we're writing some things on these rocks. Serena sometimes comes and loves to bring rocks and paint them or write words on them. And you know what? You write a word like faithfulness. You write a word like love. You write a word like sons and daughters. And you put it in your home as a place to remind you that he has gone before you and he is going before you. And maybe that's just a little practical visual that you can have in your home that will help remember.
So we know which one of us is the creative one. You know, I would just get a piece of paper and a pencil, you know, stick it on the fridge, you know, make a list, you know, use Excel if you want to, right? I mean, that's there's Dave coming out saying, hey, let's do same thing. And you know what? If Excel is yours, the way you want to do it, feel free. If you want to do a rock, but and again, our heart and the whole point of today's show is that really change is inevitable. That 2018, things are going to change, whether you affect those changes or whether those changes just affect you. They're going to happen. And so knowing that the Lord goes before you and giving ourselves, whether it's a song like Moses gave the Israelites or whether it's a rock that you put in your house or whether it's a Excel spreadsheet detailing your big picture things that you want to do, whatever it is that you want to do, take some time. If you haven't done it in the last number of weeks, set some time aside in your schedule to get together with your family, to spend some time even just by yourself to go, all right, what is 2018? What are some of the things that I want the Lord to remind me of as we navigate the change that is going to happen in 2018? Because it is going to happen.
Right. And if you're finding that you need help with accountability, or you need a coach, or you need to find out what God's word says, mm-hmm. because as we've read, it is not a futile thing for us to follow the word of the Lord. It is life for us. Mm-hmm. And I mean, ultimately, the word we know is Jesus, right? But his words to us bring life. And you may need to dig into finding a place, like Dave's already said, some people to be accountable to. And that's another practical thing, just to help you walk through your finances.
Good. Oh, a little exhale there, Reb.
That was fun.
That was a mouthful.
It was.
We are coming to the end of the first show in 2018, and it has zoomed by. We've been all over the place. But I do want to remind you of where you can pick up old archive shows. So again, we're on iTunes. If you search Let's Talk Money with Dave and Reb, you'll find the podcast there. We're also on Google Play. We're in the App Store now. So those are some new things. Of course, you can always find it on morethanenough.ca and chri.ca, as we have all the shows up there. Why don't we just close in some prayer? So, Lord, we thank you for the new year. We thank you that you are constantly changing. I mean, again, I'm reminded of any of the scenes that we see of the heavenlies in Scripture. There's just motion and things happening and change. And Lord, I'm not going to say you're the author of change, but you certainly walk through those changes with us. And so I thank you that we can have great confidence to know that the King of the universe, the God who created the heavens and the earth, is walking before us into this new year. And so we just thank you for that, and we commit this new year into your hands. And so, Lord, we pray all of these things in Christ's name. Wow. Thanks for joining me, Reb.
Thanks. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, so good. All right, we're going to wrap it up again. If you need to see some archive shows, chri.ca, morethanenough.ca, iTunes. If you do go on iTunes or Apple Play and you want to leave a comment, feel free to do that. We always love the rating. And
or any radio show suggestions, you can go to our Facebook page, and More Than Enough, and send us a note.
Great. Thanks, and join us next week as we talk money.
Let's Talk Money is a division of More Than Enough Financial Fitness, where God is transforming hearts and bringing hope for today and freedom for tomorrow. For more information or to comment on today's show, please visit morethanenough.ca.